Sanal, welcome to Art House Asia Film Festival. So, I will start out asking you one question. During your masterclass also, you gave a vivid story about your childhood and how you came into filmmaking. So, what I found is it was very, very diverse kind of thing. It means you did a law graduation, then you went to Saudi Arabia. So, how has been your journey ultimately into films?
I think from my starting of my memory onwards, I feel that I've become a filmmaker only.
Okay.
And I don't know how this idea came into me, but I can remember when a school teacher asked what you are going to become, then I'm the only one person saying that I'm becoming a filmmaker. And it was like a crazy idea for everyone, because people wanted to become doctor, engineer, you know, school teacher, and these things, but I felt that film is the medium. It was like I thought first that I would become an actor, and then slowly I understood that it is not acting, it is like making films. And I was so stubborn on that idea that I would become that only, and there is no other way. My father badly wanted me to become a doctor because I had a lot of sickness, diseases in my childhood. So we are actually a very lower class, middle class family. So he was not having a job when I was born, and he got a job when I was 5 years old or something. Then till then he was suffering a lot. So every now and then when he took me to hospital, he had to pay money and he had to beg for money to save my life and all. So he thought, he was advising me, become a doctor and give free treatment to whoever comes to you. But he was such a noble person, but I said, no, it is not my kind of stuff. But he was not ready to understand me. He said, filmmaking is not for you, because it is for big people, you need money. And I felt that, I don't know from where this stubbornness came to me. I felt that, okay, this is the only thing I can become. So I was, after my matriculation, I told him that I want to become a filmmaker. I want to go to FTIAM. And he said, no way. Because you are crazy. That's what he said. You are crazy. You don't know what is going around,
right?
And you don't know the reality. So you do whatever, but you go out from this room. So I couldn't do anything. Then I thought, okay, I'll take a middle path. I will become a lawyer. because there is an actor, Mammootty.
Yeah.
He, and I read somewhere that he became a lawyer to become a actor. So becoming a lawyer give you some kind of dignity. So with that dignity you can approach people saying that, see, I have a profession. So I am coming here because of pure passion. It is not like because of I thought, okay, I will become also a lawyer. Then that happened. And after becoming a lawyer, I could understand that, it is not easy. Because whenever I approach people, they are asking, oh, you are a lawyer, you have a good profession, why are you coming to filmmaking? They themselves not thinking that, filmmaking is a good profession.
Yeah, yeah.
And it is something got to be followed.
Right.
So I thought it is not going to be easy. And then I started making a short film by gathering a few people around me. Created a film society, Kaisha Film Forum. I made a short film in 2001. But that also was a failure at that time.
Yeah.
Because I couldn't screen it anywhere. Then I went to Saudi Arabia, and there is a lot of story. I can write 2 or 3 books.
So eventually it turned out to Sexy Durga. Before that,
it turned out to be Oral Pukkam is
Oral Pukkam
is my first film, and Oral Pukkam gave me that insight that you can do it. You can do it because earlier I also have a problem that, you know, you have no money, you have no background, nobody is going to support you.
Right.
So it is very difficult for you to become a filmmaker. So I gave up the idea of becoming a filmmaker and went to Saudi Arabia. Then I was there working 1.5 years. And I think, you know, there is a conspiracy happening around you from the universe. So it will come to you eventually. It will come to you. And I don't feel that these desires happening just because of, you know, you are fond of it.
Yeah.
I think it is. It is something else. It is. There are a lot of connections. You bump into people who have the same wavelength.
Right.
And you slowly understand that, you know, okay, your desire has some strength and it is possible. So, yeah, in 2007, I was so desperate. I thought everything is gone. I end up as a white collar, you know, Saudi Arabia, there is nothing, just, you know, you have hardly 3 hours of job, and the rest of the time you sit in front of a computer, and I have a lot of friends there. They are all happy because nothing to do, 3 hours of job, and the rest of the hours you will be blah blah, and you will be talking politics, whatever is happening in Kerala, and they are happy. They think that they are leading the way to people in Kerala, and you know. So I thought it's totally devastating. I thought my life is gone. Then I started writing poem. I started a blog and started writing poem. I connected to people all around the world. So then I put this short film I made in 2001 in blog, and I connected to people. So then people came to me. Actually, I was not trying to make another film. People came to me and asked, why you are not making another one? Then I said, it is very difficult because I was trying really hard. It is not easy for me to make a film now, because I had to borrow money to come here also. So I have a family back there. At that time, I had 2 kids. So it is totally difficult to go back and make a film. Then this guy, this Manikandan, who wrote Soda together, so he said, there is a script, I have a script, and if you are ready, we can go and make a short film, and if you don't want, you can come back. Then I said, okay. I asked my wife, can I come back and make this short film, and if it is not working, then I will come back. Then she said, okay, no problem. Then next month, it was in August or September, he said this. November I took leave, and I came to Kerala, we shot it, and after this I felt that, okay, this is my job, because I was not having any experience in making film, but it was like flowing. So people, everyone was believing me, everyone was working, and there was a famous actor in that film. And he was saying that, okay, after 5 years, I won't be able to stand with you because you will become a big filmmaker. That was such a huge compliment that I thought, okay, why this guy is saying this? So I have something. So I talked to my wife and said, okay, I'm going to stay here at least two years. Let's see what happened. Then she said, okay, it is your call. You do whatever you like. Then nothing was working out at that time also. Then I started going back to profession, a lawyer. Then it is very hard to, in Kerala, our literacy rate is huge. And everyone knows everything. And even in court, there are 2,000, 3,000 lawyers. And it is a huge competition to survive. So it was not working out. Then I thought I would go back. Then suddenly one person came to me, asked if I can write a short film for him. Then, so it is all about passion and your belief on your passion.
Right.
It will work out. That's what I feel. Sometimes I felt that it is going totally wrong, and I am doing injustice to my family, and I am killing my instincts, and I can make some money. That also I am not doing. Still, I'm not making that much of money, and so, but I'm happy because whatever I'm doing, it's fruitful. So, then this film happened, Flog happened, I got an award.
Mm-hmm.
There onwards, it is like, it is very smooth. People came to me and asked why you are not making another movie. Now also people, there are a lot of people coming to me saying that, you know, I want to produce a movie. So I'm so happy. Now it is in track.
Right. So coming to Chola, how did the idea of Chola come to you? Why did you decide to make that?
It was in this incident. There was a real real life incident happened in 1996, and at that time I was in school.
Mm-hmm.
So that had an impact on me.
Mm-hmm.
A girl was taken away from her home atmosphere, and she was raped by 32 people, and they were taking her for almost 2 months. And people were asking, when she was taken back to her home, people were asking, who are these people? Why they are doing this? It is not like that. They were just asking why this girl was not responding. Why this girl was not trying to escape. And that ended there. But later on, even the court was asking, this lady, this girl is not trustworthy. She didn't try to escape. So that was the trigger. Why, a girl of at that time school, at my school days, I was thinking, hey, if that happened to me, I would be totally destroyed.
Yes.
Totally destroyed means your mental condition, you'll be totally mentally imbalanced. So you can't say that you'll do in particular way.
Mm.
And most of our people don't treat kids as kids.
Mm.
They think that kids also should behave in a manner you behave.
Mm.
So I think there is some cultural problem, there is a social issue, it's not understanding people, and why we are not asking why it is happening, why this particular incident or instance is happening, why we are not looking into the mindset of weak and underprivileged. We are just imposing and we are just saying that you should also behave in the way we behave.
Right.
So that was the trigger of the film. And me and Manikandan started writing in 2010. It's long after that.
Right.
And at that time, there was, I think, Madhavi Kutty.
Kamala
Surayya. She made a statement that, sexual abuses are actually just another abuse. Just another atrocity. You should not carry the burden with you all the time.
Mm-hmm.
It's just like you got a slap. You retaliate or it is gone. But a sexual abuse, you take it as a burden. Oh, you are totally destroyed.
Right.
There is no way to go back. You can't come up. That kind of feel, why you are carrying that kind of feeling?
Mm-hmm.
So these questions triggered me to write these things. Then it was like the first time when we wrote, it was Murikil Bokal. The title was different. And after around 8 years, I think I had totally different outlook.
Mm.
So I changed a lot what I wrote at that time. Yeah, that has happened now.
Okay. So in Chola, I watched it in the Art House Festival. So in Chola, what I found unique is how you treated the film, especially the use of, what I found is, I thought that nature in the film was a unique character itself.
Yeah.
You had treated, was it a conscious decision to show that kind of a...
For me, nature is not trees and rivers,
mm-hmm.
It is including you,
yeah.
You are also a part of nature. So, and if the way you behave in a particular nature will be different when you are situated in a different condition.
Mm-hmm.
So, for me, it is very important. So, I don't believe in going too much close to a person or the actor. I feel that keeping them inside their nature because people behave totally different in their different kind of atmosphere. at home there will be different, in road there will be different, in train there will be different, because everything actually affects them. It's the kind of connection you don't understand, but you will get tremendously influenced. Mm-hmm. So for me, nature is actually, nature is like not nature, you know, as you say, mm-hmm. it is nature of you also,
yeah.
your nature also. Mm-hmm. So for me, it is very important that, you know, you show mm-hmm. where these people are.
Mm-hmm.
And sometime, I think, you know, if take the story of Chola, if you take out the entire story and what is happening earlier, then all other things are very beautiful. The waterfall, the trees, the forest, the road, everything is very beautiful. But if you keep both together, then it is actually troublesome. It's fearful. It make you uncomfortable.
Mm.
It don't make you okay watching. Okay, Kerala is very beautiful. I don't think that anybody will watch it like, oh, Kerala is very beautiful. It is not.
Yeah. So you have yourself formed a film forum, and you also run your own independent film festival. I think in Coimbatore.
In Kerala.
In Kerala also. So. How means, and you have said somewhere that you would make sure that you do these film festivals in small cities, mm-hmm. not the bigger cities.
Mm-hmm.
So why is that?
Because Kerala Festival, IFFK, started in 1998 or 1997, I think. And after IFFK, our entire film culture changed.
Mm-hmm.
Now we have a huge audience for art films in Kerala. I think because of IFFK. IFFK introduced people to a different kind of cinema,
mm-hmm.
Aesthetics.
Mm-hmm.
So people are now open to accept cinema. Like otherwise, I don't think that my films, no of my films will be accepted in Kerala. Because it is a totally different kind of cinema I am making. Then I am very sure about it.
Mm-hmm.
So the very important thing is that you need to feed or you need to build the community before you introduce a different kind of cinema.
Right.
So now we have audience in metropolitan cities because they are open to, you know, the kind of cinema, like they may be downloading some stuff from internet,
mm-hmm.
or there are some screenings.
Mm-hmm.
So only people, a creamy layer has access to the kind of cinema we are talking about.
Mm-hmm.
But I think we need to penetrate into the villages,
mm-hmm.
You know, small towns,
mm-hmm.
make small communities.
Mm-hmm.
Then only people will accept these kind of cinema. Otherwise, people think that cinema is, you know, cinema should give some message.
Mm-hmm.
Every time when I participate in some Q&A, at least one person will ask, what is the message? So that means they are still looking forward a message.
Mm-hmm.
And that is the case in commercial cinema.
Mm-hmm.
Because in commercial cinema, people are clapping because they get a message.
Mm-hmm.
They don't think that whether that message is useful.
Yeah.
And message is giving some kind of changes in their real, you know, life.
Mm-hmm.
It's not like that. They are totally unbothered about it.
Right.
They are happy even if it is not working.
Mm-hmm.
They are happy if there is a message, and that message is, I don't think that this it is of any use,
mm-hmm.
because you are not indulging in it.
Mm-hmm.
You take it, okay, that's a message. It is like, you know. It's like you see some messages on the walls of some churches. You read it and you don't implement in your life.
Mm.
Because it is not yours. You just take it as an entertainment.
Mm.
It is just a piece of poem, two lines of poem.
Mm.
And you take it. Maybe you take it for advising somebody else.
Yes.
You will not take it for, you know, enlightening you. Or making some changes in yourself. So that will happen only if you think,
yes.
you invest your mind. So I'm trying to make films which demand people to invest their mind. But it is very hard. It is very difficult to get people invest their mind, because people don't want. People are basically lazy.
Right.
It is like physical laziness also is similar to mental laziness also similar to physical laziness.
Right.
So it need a little bit of trial and error. So we need to constantly do this. So you need to introduce them to kind of cinema, and it is not. It should not be limited to cities. It should go to small towns and villages. That is why I am constantly saying that we need to introduce these things to people.
So what made you come to Art House Asia Film Festival with your film? And what has been your experience in the last few years?
It's very nice. Actually, we need a lot of festivals like Art House Asia. Because for me, IFFI and I'm looking at IFFI, MAMI and IFFK, taking all these three things. I feel that these are all under the clutches of the authority.
So, institutions.
Yeah, institutions. So that is going to ruin the entire idea of freedom, the investing mind.
Yeah.
They are also trying to give some kind of messages. Maybe it is not the messages the commercial cinema is giving, but it is the messages they want to push.
Right.
So we need a little bit of more, anarchy kind of thing. Very unique, open, informal.
Yeah.
Kind of thing. I don't believe that every festival will remain informal. Because on the go, it will become formal and formal and formal and institutionalized.
Yeah.
And it will lose
its
track.
Yeah.
And maybe Art House Asia also, I don't know, because now it is starting and it will go up. And unless we are so consciously watching what is happening, it is going to be institutionalized.
Yeah.
So for the time being, I feel that it is very good. And but we need more people.
Right.
We need more people to come, and we need more people to watch. But it will happen.
Yes.
But we need to be very conscious that at a point there is a tendency to become institutionalized.
Yeah.
And that is the most troublesome part of keeping a festival.
Right. So thank you very much, Sanal, for giving us time. It was a pleasure talking to you.
Thanks.
Thank you very much.